A very good afternoon, guys. How are you all doing? So we are here again. So today's topic is air and water. So how many of you are excited to learn these two topics? So let me see who all have joined us today. So we have Aishwarya as usual. She's always there and she's the first one to join, isn't it? Right, good Aishwarya. So sweet of you. Now the next one that we have is we have Tinkle. This is not Tinkle. What's your name, bacha? Let me know. Quickly, let me know. Okay, I'm starting the class. Oh, all right, Pratibha, thank you. So, hi, Akansha. How are you doing? So, great, guys. We have, right, so we have how many children there? Let's see. Yes, Akansha, we do have Menti. So now let me quickly introduce myself for all those who are new to my class or who will be watching the session later on. So guys, this is me, your educator, Shruti Sharma, a qualified and experienced science teacher. I have an experience of teaching for over 12 years on various platforms, guys. So I have helped my learners, mentored them for so many examinations, and apart from teaching, I love to read, paint, and I'm really fond of gardening and traveling. So this is me, your educator. I hope you are following me on the Unacademy platform, and you have also subscribed to our CBSE channel on YouTube, right? All of you, Unacademy channel. Great guys. So who all are there? Quickly, yeah, keep on writing. I'm reading your chat. So guys, as you people know that how good this Unacademy platform is. This is India's largest growing online learning platform. So here we provide different types of classes like special, plus, YouTube. So guys, all the classes like you people are attending are free for you. But if you want to enjoy the maximum benefits of this Unacademy platform, then you must take your personalized subscription, which is the plus subscription. Because if you take that, you get live classes for all the subjects on daily basis. You get your weekly quizzes, doubt solving sessions, practice question sessions, or test series, right? And like you know, exams are right there, so you will also be provided with the study material. All right, we are covering the syllabus as per your requirements, as per the board that you people are in. And there are many, many more features that you people would come to know if you are there with us on this Unacademy Plus platform. So you are here, Pratibha. Hi, great Pratibha. I hope you're doing well. How are you doing? Hi, Purna. Plus subscription. Yes, Purna, you can watch the sessions, definitely. So guys, as I told you about the plus, so plus is good, really good. But if you take Iconic, it is a little better. Why? Because you get everything that you're getting in plus, but along with that, you get your personal mentor, you get your live doubt solution sessions, and we connect with your parents and whatever queries, problems, or things that they need to discuss with the mentor, they can. And we do provide you with a study planner. So isn't it good? So here are the pricing plans, guys. So for the 6 to 12 plus subscription, here are the pricing plans, and this is for Iconic. So as you can see here, if you go for a 1 month subscription, you are getting it for 3,000. But if you take the 6 month subscription, you are getting 44% off, and those 6 months would be just for 10,000. So you can see that as you go for a longer duration, it becomes cheaper and cheaper and much more economical. And for your thing only, we have this code SHR Live. My name is Shruti, so it is SHR Live. So if you use this code, you will get additional 10% discount. So please do take an Academy subscription, whether you want to go for Plus or Iconic. Use this code for taking that. Hi Gitika, how are you doing? I hope you are doing good. Hi Gitanjali. Oh great. So all my students are here. Great. So guys, quickly share the link with all your friends so that everybody can join in within 2 minutes, and then we would begin with our session on air and water. So guys, as we know that we can't study all the time, we need different activities to keep us like entertained or for our all-round development. So we have different corners like book lovers corner, orators corner, entertainers corner, where you people are provided with lot many activities to learn. And we do have beyond school syllabus. We have 13 courses which are running right now on Indian history through ages, financial literacy, robotics, and much, much more. So you can go on the An Academy platform and you can figure out that what suits you best. And here we have the pricing plans. So guys, for 1 month it is for 3,000, but if you go for 6 months, again you are getting 44% off. So as I told you, like, if you go for a longer duration, it will be much, much more economical. So please use this code again, SHR Life, to take the discounts, guys. So additional 10% discount. Hi. Yes, Aishwarya, don't worry, I'll definitely take. But are these classes SS08? Oh my, guys, remember this. Yes, guys, my code is SS08, also Shruti Sharma 08. Now this is for YouTube and that is for my plus or special classes. So any code you can use. So great, I am overwhelmed that you people know and you remember. Great, so please do use that. So now let's learn the chapter Air Around Us. So how many of you are ready? We know all about plus subscription, all right, Gitika. So guys, let's learn about that. So quickly tell me, what do you know about air? Tell me fast. I hope all of you have liked the video. Yes or no? Have you all liked the video? All those, firstly you got confused, all right. So yes, you have. Great, and you have subscribed to the channel. So guys, we are going to talk about two important topics, which are air and water. And you know, we can't do without air, we can't do without water. So for survival, we need air, we need water. So these are the two natural resources that we are going to talk about. So first of all, let's talk about air. Guys, what is air? Tell me. If I ask you what is air, so what would you say? Now, you know, air, it is actually a mixture of gases and dust particles. So all those things, all the gases which are there, they are mixed and they are having dust particles along with that. So that is called air. So when you look around, can you see something? No, but you can feel, right? So it is actually a clear gas. That means you can't see. It is transparent, right? Well done. Keep on writing, guys. Keep on writing. In which living things breathe and they live. So air is a matter. Why? Because it has volume and mass. So anything which has mass and occupies space is called a matter. So air is definitely a matter. Though we can't see that, but we can feel that. And if you try to blow some air in the balloon, can you see that? The shape of the balloon changes. So that means air fills that. So that has volume and it also creates atmospheric pressure. Any questions, guys? Any questions? Akansha, I've just taught you that, for example, let me show. Look at this. For example, you have a balloon. Okay, you have a balloon. So when you fill air in that, do you blow balloon for your birthdays? Right? So when you fill air in that, you see that the shape of the balloon changes. So what is there inside that? No doubt. All right. So what is there inside that? That is air. So these are some of the important properties of air. So tell me, how much do you know about it? Quickly keep on writing. I want you people to write down in the chat box. Though I have in front of me, quickly, let me know. Yes, please, guys, hurry up. Hurry up. Great. Keep on writing. I'm waiting for your answers. What you know about air? Please let me know. Yeah. Great, guys. So we have, yes. Well done. It is essential for life. It is present everywhere. And what else? So guys, you can't see air, right? It is tasteless. If you try to taste it is all around. You just have some air in your hand and just try to gobble it, and you will see that you will feel that it is tasteless. There is no taste, and it is odorless. That means there is no smell, and air is transparent. That's why we are able to see through, right? So what is there in between me and you? Between me and camera, actually, because you are able to see me through camera. So guys, that is air, and air is transparent. That's why I am able to see you. Sorry, you are able to see me. I can't see you. So it is essential for our life, is it? It dissolves in water. Wonderful. Yes, it does dissolve in water. Now the next one that we have is, okay, it occupies space, as I told you, and it has weight. And it is present everywhere. It is all around us. It is present in water. It is present in soil. So keep on writing, guys. I'm waiting for your answers. Quickly, quickly, quickly. Yes. So, hi Gitanjali, not here, but yes, in the special class or the plus class, I will. I'll definitely will. What did you didn't you understand, Gitanjali? Latent heat of fusion. Bacha, that demands a little more understanding and a little more like brief about the topic. So that I will take up in that class. Right now I'm talking about the properties of air and water, and others will not able to understand. All right, bacha. But I'll definitely take up your topic, so don't worry. So air dissolves in water. All right, that's why you can see bubbles in the water, isn't it? Tell me. And air can be compressed easily. Can you give me one example where you can compress the air? Tell me one example where you can compress the air. I'm waiting. It's okay, Gitanjali bacha. I'm there to help you out. So don't worry. So it exerts pressure also. All right, it exerts pressure. So these are the properties of air. All right. Now, what is the composition of air? So now you know that air is all around you, isn't it? And I told you that air is a mixture. Air is a mixture. So what does air contain? Air contains mainly oxygen, nitrogen, noble gases, carbon dioxide, water vapor, and different other gases and dust particles. So these are the things, right? Well done, Bhumika. Yes, you can compress the air in the bottle. So the bottle which has nothing, which appears that it has nothing, if you compress it, it actually has air, and you can compress that, right? We have menti, don't worry. Yeah, krypton is also a gas. It is a noble gas, bacha. Akansha, hi Adwe, how are you doing? Hi Adwe, how are you doing, bacha? So air contains nitrogen in 78%, oxygen 21%, and 1% is other gases, right? So now if we talk about the composition of all the gases and what role do they play, so let's quickly discuss. So we have carbon dioxide that makes only 0.03% of the volume of the air which is around us. And you know, this carbon dioxide is very, very important. Why? Because it helps in photosynthesis, isn't it? It helps in photosynthesis. And whenever we breathe out or whenever combustion takes place, then carbon dioxide is released, isn't it? Well done. Great, guys. Next one that we have is water vapor. You know, air has some amount of water vapor also, but that depends upon place to place. For example, if the air around your place is dry, then there will be less water vapor. But if there is a lot of humidity, there is sea around your place, there are rivers around your place, then you would find that there the air which is around you, it has more amount of water vapor, isn't it? So guys, this is really important because it helps in maintaining the water cycle in nature. So as we know, when air comes in contact with a cool surface, it gets cooled and fog appears, isn't it? Now it is winters, you must be seeing the fog all around. So how does it happen? Do you know that? Quickly let me know. Great, guys. Now, guys, as I told you, we have dust particles also in air, and these dust particles also vary from place to place. Now, one of the most important things which is there in air, what is that? It is oxygen. We all know we can't live without. We can't do without. All living things need oxygen. And even for burning, we need oxygen, right? So burning, respiration, we need oxygen, and it makes up almost 21% of the volume of the total air, right? Thank you so much, S. So if you really like my voice, then please keep on listening to me and keep on attending my sessions. Thank you so much. And if you have any doubt, do let me know. All right. So, yes, guys. So we were talking about oxygen, that how important it is. And you know, when photosynthesis takes place, oxygen is released into the atmosphere. So we take oxygen for breathing, all right, respiration, and for burning. And oxygen is given out in the atmosphere because of photosynthesis. And that's how the balance of oxygen is maintained. Now, the next important thing, the major portion of the air is composed of nitrogen. You know, it takes almost 4/5 of the space that air fills, because the percentage is 78%. So 78% out of 100, that means almost 4/5 of the volume is taken up by nitrogen. And you know, nitrogen does not support burning. Are we clear? Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Aishwarya, Bhumika. Thank you for your lovely words. I hope I keep on teaching you with the same enthusiasm. Now, great, guys. Now, this is weathercock. How many of you have seen it? Quickly tell me, how many of you have seen it? You know, this weathercock, it is something which shows you, which tells you that in which direction air is moving. All right. Okay. Now, guys, this next thing. Thank you so much. Please concentrate, bacha. Quickly. You have seen it in farms. Well done, Ashok. Great. Keep on answering. Keep on telling me. Because when you relate with what I teach, you definitely understand better, isn't it? Great. So Ashok says that he has seen the weathercock in the farms. So all of you, please do look around. And this time, if you actually see that, just keep a note that why it is there. Oh, great. Your name is Vaishnavi. Hi, Vaishnavi. Hope you're doing good, bacha. Now, guys, you know, what is atmosphere? We say that there is a thin blanket of air around our earth, isn't it? Because we know that there is vacuum in space. That means there is no air in space. But there are layers of air around us. And you know, this layer, atmosphere, it is further divided into 5 distinct layers. You know, what are they? Hi, Bhumika. Oh, you have seen it in cartoons. All right. But wherever you have seen it, no. So that is important. So you know, what does it do? Oh, great, guys. So guys, I hope all of you, Vaishnavi, I hope you have subscribed to our YouTube channel, bacha. So now these 5 layers, name them, quickly write down in the chat box. Troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, and exosphere. So these are the 5 main layers that you can see around our earth, and you know, they play a major role. Hi Ritania, how are you doing? Yaar, yes bacha, yes, you're right. Hi Ritania, hope you're doing good. So guys, these are the 5 layers which are really very, very important for us. And you know, as we go up, air becomes thinner and thinner. All right. So let's talk about all of these layers. So troposphere, which is the first layer, which is nearest to our surface, right? Then it is responsible for the weather conditions, and it contains about more than 75% of the atmosphere, right or not? So it is the first layer nearest to the surface, which is responsible for the weather conditions, and it contains almost 75% of the atmosphere. So it is the nearest layer to Earth. Can you see it in the diagram? All right. I know, but you know which is the layer which has a maximum temperature? Tell me. Hi, Brijendra. Quickly let me know which is the layer which has a maximum temperature. I'll let you know. Don't worry. So we have stratosphere, which is a layer which is just above the troposphere. And you know, it contains the ozone layer. What does it contain? Ozone layer. And you know, in this layer, aeroplanes fly, and it is home to most of the clouds. So if you have ever traveled in the aeroplanes, so you go to a certain height, right? So actually you are traveling in the next layer of atmosphere, which is stratosphere. Great. Oh, well done. Great. Next, guys, is the mesosphere. You know, it is the third after troposphere. We have stratosphere, which has the ozone layer also. Then the third one we have is the mesosphere. Now it is the coldest layer. And you know, right after the coldest layer, we have the other layer, which is the fourth and the hottest layer of Earth. And that is having the temperature almost 1500 degrees Celsius. The air is very thin here. And you know, 99% of the atmosphere lie below this. Yeah, thermosphere is the hottest, right, guys? Now, next. This is exosphere. This is, you can see that. Now, I think you will be able to relate that, isn't it? Tell me. So, troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, and the last layer, which is, which has all the satellites, spaceships, everything, molecules and atoms which escape into space, everything is there, and that is exosphere. So, are we clear? Yeah, great, Adwe. So, that is what it is. So, I hope you have understood. Now, we are done with one topic, which was air. Now let's move on to the next important natural resource, which is water. So tell me, how many of you say that, agree to my saying that water, water everywhere, nor any drop to drink? Have you heard this? That, you know, our planet is filled with water. You know, Earth's surface is covered with water about 3/4 in ratio. Isn't it? Almost 75% of Earth is covered with water. Yes, Bhumika, we are coming on to the Menti quiz, so don't worry. So now, all right, so guys, you know what happened? The Earth is called the blue planet, the water planet, because of the reason that 75% of the Earth is covered with water. But in spite of that, we always talk about the scarcity of water. We always talk about the problems which are created because of non-availability of water. So why is it so? Let's talk about. Now, here we go. You know, there is a lot of water around us, but out of that, 97% of the water is there in seas and oceans as salt water, which is too salty and it cannot be used for drinking, right? Now, the next one that we have is, look at this. I think you will be able to understand with this way. Now, guys, look at this. What can you understand from this? Yeah, great. Hi, Priyal. How are you doing? Hi, Priyal. You know, water on Earth that we have are out of all the water. If we say that we have 100% water, 97% of the water is the salty water. Now, the rest of the 3% water, which is not salty, that is present, which is available to us, but out of this, most of the water is in the form of polar ice caps, right? And just 1% of water is available for us. So that is very little water which is present in rivers, lakes, and ponds for us to drink and to Do all our household chores? Yes or no? Tell me, what do you think? How much water is there for us? Aren't we facing the scarcity of water? Icebergs, right. This is not exact. Obviously, this is not exact, right, guys? So now, the next one. No, guys, ionosphere is different. बच्चे देयर आर डिफरेंट लेयर्स सी हाई यस देयर आर डिफरेंट लेयर्स बट दोज आर द मेन लेयर्स बच्चा आई लेट यू नो ओके डोंट वरी आई लेट यू नो आई टेल यू अगेन सो गाइज जस्ट जस्ट फ्यू स्लाइड एंड देन वी आर मूविंग टू मेंटी देयर आर मेनी क्वेश्चन सो डोंट वरी सो गाइज वी हैव वाटर विच इज प्रेजेंट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ सॉलिड लिक्विड एंड गैस राइट एंड Where do we use water? Quickly let me know where do we use water? What are the different uses of water? Oh, you are Sarthak Saxena. All right, Sarthak. Sarthak, I let you know, bacha. Now, these are actually the main layers, and those layers contain ionosphere and this thing that you are talking about. Okay. So, ionosphere is a. All right, you use that, right? You use that for. Bathing for you use that for agriculture you use that for many other personal or domestic needs you use it for manufacturing purposes isn't it so you know out of all the water that we have so out of all the water most of the water almost 70% of the total water we have it is used for agriculture for growing of crops okay and Out of the remaining 30%, almost 20 to 22% is there for industries. Right, great. For industries. And the remaining 8% that we have, we are left with, it is available for our personal use. For example, when we talk about the personal use, you can say that washing, drinking, cleaning, all right. Cooking and many more such things and even recreation. All right, we use water for recreation as well. So where do we use it for recreation? Can you tell me? Have you ever been to the water parks? Let me know. How many of you have been to the water parks? Quickly let me know. Great. Great guys. So that's how we use water. And where do we get water from? The most important or the prime source of water that we have is the rain water. And then we have this surface water and ground water. So we have lakes, ponds, streams, rivers, so many of them. And if we talk about the ground water, we have open wells, tube wells, springs, so many of them. Yeah, there are too many couples. All right. Great, guys. So, Now, let's talk about water cycle. What do you understand by the term water cycle? Let me know. Hurry up. We are talking about that. Quickly, let me know. Oh, hi, Harman. Mentee, please. Yes. So, you wait for, Sarthak, you wait for just 2 minutes and we will begin with Mentee. So, can you wait for 2 more minutes? This is the last topic that we have. So, you quickly let me know what is water cycle. So it is actually the continuous circulation of water in nature. And you know how it happens? First of all the water which is there in the water bodies or in the plants, it evaporates. It moves from this bottom, from this earth to the air. So water changes into water vapor. So that is what is evaporation. All right. And after evaporation occurs, when these water vapor go into the like air high up, then this water vapor condenses because of the low temperature. Great. Well done. Keep on writing, guys. This water vapor changes to water again. So do we have Gitanjali right now? Hi. So who is there? Shiv Shakti. All right. Hi, Shiv Shakti. I hope you're doing good. and you have already liked the video of the class and you are already subscribed. All right, evaporation and boiling, they have a lot of difference. Like evaporation can take place at any temperature, but boiling requires a specific temperature to happen. All right, and evaporation is a surface phenomena, whereas boiling is not. So condensation is when water vapor changes to water, and this water, it gets collected in the clouds. So clouds are formed when water vapor condenses. Now these clouds become so heavy because of the water which it has, and then precipitation occurs. You know what happens? From these clouds, the water comes out as rain, snow, sleet, hail, depending upon the temperature of the place. So that is what is precipitation. So this is step one, this is step two, this one is step three, and after precipitation, what happens? So the water which has gone up has come down again, so it gets collected in various ways, right? Fixed temperature, yeah, for boiling there is a fixed temperature, like water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, so every liquid has a different temperature at which it begins to boil. Are we clear? But evaporation, it takes the heat from the surroundings and the liquid changes into the vapor. All right, and because of evaporation, cooling occurs, which does not take place in case of boiling. Are you clear, bacha? Saksham, you tell me, beta. Sarthak, right? You are Sarthak. Tell me. All right. So that is, no. Boiling requires a fixed temperature. You want me to explain? I let you know. Tell me. Wait. Boiling actually, it occurs at fixed temperature, whereas evaporation can occur at any temperature. And boiling, it is a bulk phenomena, whereas evaporation is the surface phenomena. That means it takes the heat from the surface and it changes its state. All right, and because of evaporation, there is cooling. Are you clear now? All right, bacha, not to worry. So guys, we know that there is a lot of water. In spite of that, we feel scarcity of water. There is insufficient water. Yes or no? Yeah, fast, within a minute. So the factors because of which we face scarcity of water are because of the increase in industries, because of the increasing population, we have more demand for agriculture, and to fulfill the needs of this ever-growing population, we need to cut down trees also so that we can build the houses, we can set up industries, and we can do many more such things. So because of all these reasons, we are facing scarcity of water. So what should we do? Tell me. But your precipitation is when water falls down from clouds to earth. All right, so that is what is precipitation. So now that's why we need to conserve water. And what are the ways to conserve water? Tell me, what are the simple ways by which you can conserve water? Like as a child, these are the simple things you can do. Like you can turn off the tap immediately after use, isn't it? You can take bath by filling water in a bucket rather than taking a shower, because shower takes a lot of water. And then do not use a full flush from the cistern in the toilet. You can actually manage, you can recycle water, you can actually reuse water. The water that you are using for cleaning your fruits and vegetables, that water can be used for cleaning purposes. The water which is being used for different uses that we have, like you can make different uses. Water harvesting. No, please, I'm not saying actually that you need not take bath. You take bath, But yes, for example, if I was giving you, like you use RO at home. So there is a lot of water which gets wasted in RO. So you can use that water. Okay, you can collect that water when you run, when you switch on the AC, there is again a lot of water which comes out. So you can collect that water, and that water you can use for various other purposes later on. So these are the simple things that you people can do and by which you can conserve water. Is it right? So guys, we are done with the revision of air and water, the main points which are related to the chapter. So I think you are prepared and you are good to go for the mentee quiz. Tell me how many of you are you good to go for the mentee quiz? Yes. So here is the code. So please quickly have the code. Great, great, great. So here is the code. Use less water for brushing. Right, Adve. So here is the code 5690951. Mentee, mentee, mentee fast. All right. So here we go. Now, here is the mentee quiz that we have. Here is the mentee quiz that we have. Let's see who all are there. There are 25 questions. There are 25 questions. Keep on, keep on, keep on. Yes, guys, quickly, quickly, quickly join. Let's see who all have joined. I will press enter once everybody joins. And once everybody, first question, yeah, you're volcano, all right. Let's see, let's see, let's see. One more, one more, one more. Okay. So can we have 20 people? Could you please quickly share the code with your friends? Could you please quickly share the code with your friends, guys, so that others can join us too? So here we are. Let's start. You are I, Sadhve. All right. You are goat, Akansha. You're rose, Shiv Shakti. Bhuvna is cake. All right. So here we go. So let me press enter. Let me have just 20 kids and then I will press enter. All right. So 1, 2, 3, and here we go. Let's quickly do that because we have many questions. So I will not give you much time. So let's see. Air is present in atmosphere, in soil, in water, of ponds, lakes, and seas are everywhere. So tell me, and I'll give you the leaderboard after every 5 questions. So don't worry. What is the answer? Where is air present? Quickly, quickly, quickly. Hurry up. Question kam kar do. Why, bacha? Tell me why. Okay. All right. You are new. Hi, Samvedya. I hope you have, after every question, air is present everywhere in soil, water, atmosphere. So that is the answer. Guys, the next question we have is the mentee code is, guys, quickly tell her the mentee code 5690951. 5690951 is the mentee code, guys. Quickly let her know. 5690951. Hurry up. Oh, okay. Don't worry, don't worry. The session is still 3. So Earth is surrounded by an envelope of gases. And what do we call that? Atmosphere, right? We call it atmosphere. So let me have the question 3. Okay, after third question, I'll show you the leaderboard. Don't worry. I'll show you. So the next one. Which of these does a fire need to burn? So, out of all the gases that we have, which gas is required by the fire to burn? Argon, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, or oxygen? It is right. It is. Quickly answer. And yeah, it is oxygen, guys. Yes, it is. Next one that we have is leaderboard. You people were waiting for that. Oh, disco potato is right here. All right. Akansha asking, then there is this. What is this name? Could you please tell me this detective with the hat and the goggles? Then VIP Monu, Mamta, Khushi, Rehan, Vaishnavi, Ishwarya. All right. Next question comes your way. You are at 11th. Adwe, don't worry. I know that you can definitely make it to top 10. So all the best. You will quickly make it to the top 10. So tell me, which of these do plants need in order to make food? So guys, you need to tell me that which gas is required by plants to make food. Hurry up. The answer is argon, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, or oxygen. Which one is that? It is, yes, it is carbon dioxide. But ye, oxygen is actually produced during photosynthesis, but carbon dioxide is required, isn't it? So the next question, which is question number 5, we have 25 questions. Okay, which of these makes up about 21% of the atmosphere? You know, out of 100%, which gas makes the maximum volume of air, and which gas is present as like in 21%? Oh, you are Shiv Shakti. All right. So I'll take your name, Shiv. I think that is better. So guys, all those who are watching, I want them to quickly like the video. Then I'll show you the next question. Quickly. Well done. Hurry up. Well done, guys. Hurry up. Oh, great. Nitrogen maximum, right? Mamta, next question we have is question number 6. Is it? Oh, I think we have missed a question. Question number 6 is there. Adve says he wants leaderboard after every question. Okay. Which of these makes up about 78% of the atmosphere? Oh, Mamta just told you all. So which one is that? I'll show you the leaderboard after that. Don't worry. Which of these makes up about 78% of the atmosphere? This is a gas which is highest volume. Okay, Adve, I will listen to you, bacha. Don't worry. I'll show you the leaderboard. I was just saving time. Okay. The answer is yes, it is nitrogen. Great, guys. It is nitrogen. Next is the leaderboard. The thing that you were all waiting for. So we have, oh, who all have made it to the leaderboard? We have Pratigya, Shubhi, new children are making it to the leaderboard. Next question is here. Hi. So who all are there? Quickly like the video first of all and then subscribe to the channel. Have you done that? All of you. Okay, moving air. What do we call moving air? The air which is in motion. Do we call it dew, fog, or wind? Answer it fast. Oh, great. Well done, Pratigya. Wow, I think you deserve a clap. All 21 answered it nicely. And this is moving air is called wind, right? Great, guys. Next question. Or leaderboard. I know you wanted leaderboard. So here we are. So any new names in the leaderboard? No, not this time. You guys have to wait. All new additions. Let's see when can it happen. So tell me this one. What is air? Air is a mixture, pure substance, an element, or anything it could be, which depends upon place. Okay, bacha. Okay, Mr. Saxena, I will let you know. So, yes, air is a mixture. Great, guys. Next question. Well done. Oh. Okay. This time, anyone who has made it to the leaderboard, Monu, Mamta, Vaishnavi, Disco Potato, Shubhi, Rehan, Pratigya, Akansha, Aishwarya, and we have Shiv. Next one is question number 9. No leaderboard, okay. All right, somebody saying, please, ma'am, show us the leaderboard after every question, and some people are saying, no, we don't need that. Acha, chalo, tell me. The ratio of nitrogen to oxygen in the air is called, is what? 1 is to 4, 4 is to 1, 3 is to 1, or 1 is to 2. Now, let me tell you how to go about this question. You know, what is the percentage of nitrogen? 78%. What is the percentage of oxygen? 21%. So, what is that ratio between them? 80 to 20%. So, what is that? Yeah, well done. Yes, bacha, it is. Vaishnavi, it is right. It is 4 is to 1. I know you people might get confused between 1 is to 4. So it is 4 is to 1. And the leaderboard is right here. Oh, great. Adwe has made it to the leaderboard finally. Great, Adwe. Congratulations. And we have Ritanya. All right. Vaishnavi on top. Next question is question number 10. So here we go. So, guys, question number 10. In which layer of the atmosphere do we live and weather is there? You failed. No, you are not failing, bacha. Don't say that you have failed. You can definitely make up to the leaderboard. Guys, there were people who are not there in the leaderboard. So please try until you succeed. So don't lose heart, don't lose hope. Just keep on trying. Yeah, the answer is troposphere. No, it's not that. Oh, well done. The next is the leaderboard, which is right here. Guys, I hope all of you have liked the video. Yes or no? How many of you? Yes, please. Okay, tell me, where is the ozone layer which absorbs UV radiation? Located in our atmosphere. Where is the ozone layer which absorbs UV radiation located in our atmosphere? Is it stratosphere, thermosphere, mesosphere, or troposphere? Okay, bacha, okay, now I will not. All right. It is stratosphere, guys. It is stratosphere. So then comes the leaderboard. And in the leaderboard, the positions are changed again. Oh, now I will show you the leaderboard after some questions, okay? Not after every question, because we have to complete the quiz as well in the given time. Okay, now tell me, which layer of our atmosphere has no outer limits? That means this is a layer where we have satellites. Okay, so I told you. Yeah. So quickly. Yeah, it is exosphere. Great. Next one. Now I told you now that the leaderboard will appear after 15th question. So you have to wait for a while. Okay, this layer is the hottest layer of the atmosphere. Which one is the hottest layer? You remember when I told you? Which one is the coldest layer and which one is the hottest layer? Troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, or thermosphere? Hi Krishna. What happened, bacha? Yeah, quickly. What happened, bacha? Krishna, tell me. You can join the menti.com. You can see, go to www.menti.com and use the code 5690951. Wow, great. Meso, the coldest, right? 15,000 degrees Celsius. Well done, Adwe. You guys remember everything. So here comes the 14th question. And 14th question says, okay, tell me which gas in the air is causing global warming. You know what is global warming? The heating up of the Earth's atmosphere, because of which the polar ice caps are melting and there could be floods, and a lot of problems are occurring because of that. So which gas in the atmosphere is responsible for that? Well done. Great guys. Keep on answering and keep on liking the video and keep on subscribing to our YouTube channel. Next one. Here we are. Oh, we have Praharsh who has come to the leaderboard now. All right, Adwe, you have gone to the second position and Ritania has come on first. Wow. Let's see what happens now. We still have 11 questions. Okay. Now the questions are on the topic water. What is water? Water is known as a solute, universal solute, solution, solvent, or bonder. Let me give you a hint. Water is something which dissolves almost everything into it. So if it is capable of dissolving things into it, what do we call it? What do we call it? Right. Solvent. Great. Perfect. Now comes the next question. You want to see the leaderboard? All right. This time, okay. One more thing, that if you answer faster, then you will get more points. So please answer correctly and answer fast. 10 more questions. Well done. Earth is covered with water. So what do we call it? A red planet, a blue planet, or a yellow planet. So our Earth is called what? Wow, all of you knew it. And yes, we call it a blue planet. Right. Next one. Okay, the leaderboard changed. Question number 70. Now I'll give you the leaderboard after 20th question. Bye, Shiv. I hope you learned something and you like the class. Quickly let me know. Water is used for. Oh, wow, you didn't take time at all. And yes, we use it for drinking, cooking, washing, cleaning, and growing crops. Right. Next question is question number 18. So let's see. Hi Pratigya. Hi Suresh. All right. We cannot use the water from oceans and seas. Why? Is it sweet? Is it salty? Is it sour or what? We cannot use the water from oceans and seas because it is very salty. Right. It is very salty. Next one. Question number 19. Question number 19. Okay, most of the Earth's water, like about 97% of it, where is it? Is it in the clouds or is it in the form of snow or ice or the salt water in the oceans or fresh water in lakes and rivers? Where is it? Answer, answer, answer. I'm waiting. I'm waiting, guys. Quickly. Hurry up. Don't know. All right. It is actually the salt water in the oceans. Next one. Okay. Question will come to you. Leaderboard will come after 20th question. Okay. So here we are. People cannot use most of the fresh water on Earth. Why? Because it is in the form of clouds, lakes, oceans, or ice. We have 3% of the water, which is the fresh water. But out of that, no, bacha. Here we are talking about fresh water. We are not talking about the salty water. So the fresh water is in the form of ice. Right. Great. Now next one. Here we go. Oh, Bhumika has also made it to the leaderboard. Wonderful. And oh, The leaderboard changed. It's okay, it's okay, it's okay. Don't worry. Here comes the 21st question. There are 5 more questions, so don't worry. Try. Always remember. Try. What is another name or synonym for the water cycle? Do we call it geologic, hydrologic, geosphere or carbon cycle? What is that? What is that? Yeah, it is hydrological cycle, right? It is. I will kill it in, oh great, never give up. Never. You are my children. How can you give up? So Ritania is on top, then Mamta, Shubhi, Akansha, Advay, Praharsh, Monu, Disco Potato, and then we have Shiv, then Bhumika. Alright. Next one. So it's not important to win, guys, all the time. What is important is learning. So till the time you are learning new things, you are actually winning, isn't it? So why is it? Now listen to me. What is it called when plants give off water vapor as a waste product? You know, there are tiny pores on the surface of leaves. Wow. It is called transpiration. When plants lose water in the form of water vapor, we call it transpiration, right? The next one is, okay, first time. All right, not to worry. Let's see what happens. Akansha was the fastest and Ritania still maintains. Aishwarya has come to the leaderboard. Wow, Aishwarya. Congratulations, bacha. Next one is question number 23. 3 more questions, guys, and 3 more minutes for the class. I hope all of you have subscribed to the channel. Okay. What is the opposite of condensation? You know, condensation is when water vapor changes to water to make clouds. So what could be the opposite of condensation? Now think before you answer. Think before you answer. It's okay. If you are learning, that's very important, bacha. It is evaporation. Great. I was thinking that you might get confused. All right, let's see what happens. Again, the positions are changing in the leaderboard. Next question. Question number 24. 2 more questions, guys. So let's see what happens to the leaderboard. Which of the following is an example of precipitation? You know what is precipitation? That after condensation, when the clouds become heavy, then the water which is collected, it comes down. So sleet, hail, snow, or all of the above. Which of the following is an example? Wow, it was really quick. So all of them, even rain, sleet, hail, snow, any of the forms, they are all precipitation, right? Great. Next one. Okay, we have the leaderboard here. I wanted to show you before the last question, and here we go. Oh, then we have again Ritania, then Advay, Mamta, Shubhi, Akansha, Praharsh, Monu, Disco Potato, Bhumika and Aishwarya. You know, I really love to take this name, Disco Potato. No, this is the last question. Please answer this, Shiv. I'm not saying you goodbye. I will not. You have to answer this question. Okay, what are formed when water vapor condenses? This is the last question. Answer. Now, when you know when water vapor goes up, oh, it is clouds, right, guys? It is clouds. Great. So, are you excited? No need to quit. Are you excited to see the leaderboard? How many of you? Then quickly, hi, Farleen. Then quickly like the video. Quickly like the video. Then I'll show you the leaderboard. 1, 2, 3, and here we go. And The answer is, oh sorry, the final positions in the leaderboard is Ritania has won, then Shubhi, then Mamta, Akansha, Monu, Adwe, Praharsh, Bhumika, Aishwarya and Disco Potato. Great guys, it was such a lovely, lovely session with you all. Great. So I hope you had a nice time, isn't it? So, one more thing guys, I would like to share with you, you know about the Ascent Championship? How many of you know about the Ascent Championship? Tell me. So we have been organizing this Ascent Championship every month. So this time it is on 10th of January. I would request you all to enroll for this championship and you could win a lot of exciting prizes. You know guys, there are many students who are right there in the session, those who won the scholarships. All right, so you can win scholarships worth rupees INR 5 lakhs. Isn't it too good? So fascinating. So guys, we have this on 10th of January and the timings are 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. All right, I think everybody is comfortable to take the exam that day because it is a Sunday. So please do get enrolled for that and prepare well. We follow the NCERT curriculum so you can strengthen your basics. You can ensure that you are prepared well before you go for that. All right. So thank you guys. I hope you had a nice session with me. So hope to see you soon, very soon. So this is your educator Shruti Sharma signing off. Bye bye guys.